J-O-N-A-T-H-A-N-W-A-T-E-R-S. And I'm the attorney for several landowners in Mitchell County and in Colquitt County. First, I just want to put on the record that I object to everyone being limited to 3 minutes. I know FERC can limit it to 3 minutes when there's a large amount of people, and we've been allocated 2 hours. We're only 30 minutes into it. There's, I want the record to reflect, there's 20 people in the audience here tonight, and there's 11 speakers. So I object first if it's been limited to 3 minutes.
I'm going to give you another 3 minutes, yeah, here. But yes.
Okay. My family's been in South Georgia since 1783. South Georgia is an area not uncommon for generations of families to grow up here. For founders of churches, their families still be going to churches. There's a litany of issues to do with this pipeline that 3 hours wouldn't do it justice. EPA did a review that basically stated there was no benefit to the state of Georgia, though innumerable costs to the state. You mentioned tonight in your PowerPoint presentation that there's going to be a compressor station in Albany, Doherty County, and there's now going to be a tap in Mitchell County. Basically, responses to objections made years ago when the pipeline first was going to come here. But I would put it to you all that those are not active customers of this pipeline. Those will not, the capacity for this pipeline was created for Florida Power & Light, and it's a redundant pipeline. I saw a letter from the director to a congressman, and not on this pipeline, another, but basically was stating what FERC does, what it does when it reviews the EIS and creates EIS. And it said, we look at the law, the facts, and the science. Okay? And I just think that in this situation, if you look at the law, a gentleman spoke today about eminent domain statute in Georgia. They're using one for a local utility, which is what they're doing. And even in the EIS, it states that a lot of people in South Georgia have been complaining about the eminent domain and how that's done. And in the EIS, FERC states that it's the certificate being issued that gives eminent domain to the Natural Gas Act to Sable to do the things they need to, for eminent domain. And that that would appear to me to be a position by, since that's a quasi-judicial proceeding with FERC, that gives a statement saying that this is what the law is on this issue. And yet, Sable's going around as a bully through South Georgia, suing individuals in these various counties over this very issue. Y'all may not know how Belgium got in World War I. The Germans wanted to send troops across Belgium in World War I. And the Germans said, hey, we will pay you to allow us to send our troops across Belgium in World War I. And the King of Belgium said, we're a country, we're not a road. South Georgia is a home. It is not an easement for a pipeline serving people in Central Florida. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Waters was our last speaker.